by Fari at the point. Nice move by Michael, trying to get around Matthew Bates. Fari backhander, and Mac is on top of him, though. Centering pass, Michael Bowes shot right on target.
But now, moves up the left baseline, head to circle, shot, score! They're going to...
Does. 3-on-2 developing. Heller with it, shoots, and a glove saved by Battleson. So he'll be in there for 4 minutes. Bauer in the middle, over far side, shot ripped. Mac with a big save on
across the blue line. Leaves it for Goodman, trying to get around Silverstein. Tried to roof it.
He scores! Knocked away. Pope slips it up towards center ice as Chappell tried to get it. Oh, and Breifogel and Pope go into the divider between the benches. Change, it turns into a 3-on-1. Bauer to Fari, shoots, and a save by Mack.
Direct by a five.
Oh, and Schulte out of the box, ahead of the pack, shoots, and a save. Excuse me, comes to Rebel Yari, fires a shot in the middle. Oh, off the leg of the defender, Orsini. Hardwick had to make the save on.
2-on-1.
He's got it, 2-on-1. Gilbert's up front, backhander, 5-hole. No, it's a save to Southwell. Southwell weaving his way through the defense, finally knocked down to the ice. Lorich gets control of it, tries to hook it towards the net. Shot, ball. Oh, a save by Lucas Franzen.
Side.
To Gebauer. Oh, and a one-timer in the middle of Solani. Barnes with it. They turn it over, those. Oh, he's drilled by Escobosa.
To the point to Markowski. Back over now to Braun. Braun walks up to Lazy. Fires a shot and scores!
Slid into the middle of Alo's shot, and that one is held by Young. With a shot, save. Mac rebound. Geely trying to put it home. Durain over there. Claire all by himself going the other way. One-on-one with Mac. He goes to the backhander, loses it. It was kicked away.
To Brakeville.
1-2 here, break go around, everybody shoots, it goes up over Patterson, they score, rolls in! It's Acuna and Ellenberger. They've got the score here, but a save by Young, rebound.
Here comes Newport-Mesa, shot, what a save right there!
First to Rebel Yar, but no one was there. Out front, Rubinsky, got it to Trucksaw, he made a save. Tips it over to Garcia, Datola stepping over, trying to take it away. He's got it, out front by himself, backdoor pass shot, score, it's Grady O'Brien! He's gonna go. Schulte hits Cooper, or Lisiaga. Oh, stood up.
Fish down low to Van Dyke. Van Dyke severing pass to Robbins. Slot shot, save, Taylor.
Three saves for him this period now.
Trucksaw trying to...
Ram shot, rebound. Oh, the glove save by the goaltender, Levaney.
This is the Anaheim Ducks High School Hockey League Weekly Report on ADHSHL.com and Black Dog Enterprises. Andy Dickerson here to recap the action from Week 8. This was our busiest week thus far with 6 games played over the 3-day weekend. Bellarmine Bales were in town for their first 4 games of the season and kicked things off on Friday versus the Santa Margarita Eagles. Emi Solani and Jake Rosenbaum gave the Eagles a 2-0 lead within the first 20 minutes of the contest. Tyler Gebauer assisted on both scores. The story of the game, though, was Bellarmine goaltender Ryan Mack, who made save after save to keep his team within striking distance. The Eagles' Jack Hardwick saw fewer shots but did his part at the other end, at least until midway through the third period when Michael Bowes tapped in a rebound chance to pull the Bells within one. Later on the power play, John Winchester blasted a point shot through traffic past Hardwick to tie the score at 2. Nothing would be settled in regulation, so we headed to overtime. In the extra frame, the Eagles continued to bombard Mack, but he turned them aside the entire time. We looked poised to head to a shootout, but never got there as the game was decided in the dying seconds.
In their zone and a running clock in overtime. 15 seconds to play. They win it. Oh, and Silver was ahead of the pack, and Bowes couldn't get it to him. Turned over, tip, out front. They score! Teemu Selanne! It's got Teemu Selanne. Emil Selanne with 8 seconds left. And in overtime, it's the Santa Margarita Eagles winning it 3-2. A hard-fought game for both teams, but Emi Solani found the seam. His second of the game is an overtime winner.
Emi Solani's second goal of the game gave the Eagles their second win of the season. Mack ended up as the hard luck loser with 45 saves. The Bells had to get over their OT loss quickly as they hit the ice a mere 15 hours later to take on the Damien Spartans. Damien tapped Anthony Barba for his first varsity start of the season, while the Bells turned to Connor Young to make his first career varsity start. Young was rudely welcomed to the division when David Myers snuck the first shot directed at Young past him. 14 seconds in, it was 1-0 Damien. Young would settle in, though, with some help from his defense, clearing out bodies and the puck from in front of the net.
Comes loose to Cherry at the top with a minute to go on the power play. His shot deflected by Suquet on net. It's in the crease and loose. Where's the puck? Body.
Early second, the Bells would get on the board when their captain, Gabe Silva, took a pass from Jared Southwell and beat Barba glove side to tie things up. Alex Chappell found a way through Barbara as well to give the Bells the lead, but Riley Trebilcock quickly responded to not the score at 2. Minutes later, Asim Jane was crushed by Evan Escoboza, but Michael Bowes pounced on the loose puck and fed it across to Sebastian Zoric, who waited out Barba before potting the eventual game winner. Alex Chappell would notch his second of the night to add insurance late, and the Bells picked up their first win of the season, 4-2 over Damien. Next up was the Varsity D2 Game of the Week between Newport-Mesa and Corona-Norco. This game turned into a battle between two top guns, Sam Weisner and Ryan Romans. Weisner struck first with a couple of slippery moves past Stingray defenders, and it was 1-0 Ice Kings. Romans responded immediately and made a statement with a natural hat trick in a span of only 7.5 minutes. The goals would keep on coming as Weisner struck again, this time tipping a Patrick Standell point shot while on the power play. Connor Webster buried one late in the first to tie the game at 3, but Romans took it upon himself to respond early in the second. His fourth of the game, this one short-handed, gave the Stingrays a 4-3 lead. Teams would trade scores once more before Dakota Risto finally put a stop to the back and forth with a power play strike to make it 6-4. Jacob Montanez pushed the lead to its largest point near the end of the frame, and it was 7-4. Didn't last long, though, as Weisner popped the water bottle with his third of the night to make it 7-5. Fast forward to late in the third, Patrick Standell went bar down as well to make it 7-6. A game-saving stop by Connor Locus preserved the lead in the final minute, and the Stingrays escaped with a wild 7-6 win. The third game of the day on Saturday was a rematch from the previous weekend as the Servite Friars took on the Orange Lutheran Lancers. Alexander Rogers got the starting goal again for Olu, and he looked sharp early, denying Friars scoring chances left and right. Midway through the first, Jacob Nelson beat Landon Pavlison to give the Lancers the early lead, one that was extended a minute later when Matt Knutson smacked home his second goal in as many weeks. Showing more resilience than the previous week when they lost 11-2, Nick Mott got in behind the Lancer defense and popped in a rebound to bring the Friars back within one. Fast forward to mid-second, Jacob Long earns a penalty shot against newly inserted Lancer tender Austin Alarcon. Long skates left and pulls the trigger, but finds iron. Later with the team's 4-on-4, Chandler Dottola slid a backdoor pass for a diving Jacob Heller. He swatted it past Pavlison to increase the Lancers' lead. Late in the period, Olu up 5-1 now. Brendan Schulte started the comeback effort with a tap-in from the doorstep. Early third, Marcelo Lisiaga with a pole drag and score to bring the Friars within two. Less than 2 minutes later, Jacob Heller took the momentum back for the Lancers by skating in from center ice, splitting two defenders and roofing a backhander past Pavlison. An insurance marker by Grady O'Brien gave Olu a 7-3 lead, but the Friars kept on coming with goals by Schulte and Lisiaga, second of the night for each of them. Alarcon shut the door down the stretch, though, to freeze the Friars at 5 goals on the night. The Friars' frustration finally boiled over at the end as the team squared off at the final buzzer. Even Alarcon got into the action with Luke Cross, but cooler heads prevailed and the Lancers walked away with their fifth straight victory. The final game of the night featured Bellarmine back on only 4 hours' rest to face off against Edison. It was clear early that this one was going to be tightly contested as goaltenders Ryan Mack and Jared Labadie were on top of their games. Mack's skills were on display early as he would eventually make 28 saves on the night. His prowess in goal allowed Alex Chappell to finally break through for the Bells midway through the second period. That gave Bellarmine a 1-0 lead and was Chappell's third goal of the weekend. Labadie was pushed to the limit in the third period but did not break again as he held the Chargers within a goal. Just when it looked like Bellarmine was going to hold the lead the entire way, Jake Pope broke away on a 2-on-1 with Drew Trucksaw, and Trucksaw finished it off to tie the score with only 1:36 left. OT decided nothing, so he went to the shootout. Here are SportsnetUSA.net's Eric Pezzolano and Chuck Lasek to describe the action.
In round one of the shootout, tied at one. Here entering the shootout, Silva's the first shooter. Labadie way out of the crease. Silva to the forehand, kicked away by Labadie.
Scored his fifth goal, the lone goal scorer for the Chargers this game.
Comes across the blue line. Out comes Mack. Trucksaw goes to the backhand. Oh, lost control of it and crossed the goal line.
Lone goal scorer for Bellarmine this game. Power play goal.
He goes wide right. Comes in on Labadie. Rister rips it off the post. To the lefty. Start right. Mack way out of the net. Pope goes to the backhand. He scores! He slipped it 5-hole on Mack. The Chargers get the first shootout goal. It's 1-0 going into the third round. Must score to keep it alive here. Bowes moving in, up the slot, shoots, he misses, and that's it! Edison wins!
Wow, outstanding game. Oh my goodness.
Of course it ended 1-0 in the shootout, right?
A great finish to a goaltender's duel. Edison comes out on top, 2-1. Last game of the weekend was an early one. 7:45 a.m. start on getaway day for Bellarmine as they took on JSerra. The goalies were the only ones making any plays early, as Lucas Franson and Connor Young were not interested in letting any pucks pass them. The offenses finally broke through in the second period, though, as Shane Gilbert snuck a backhander under the arm of Young to give the Lions the lead. Gabe Silva responded late in the frame by beating Franson 5-hole to tie the score. In the third period, Jared Southwell used Silva as a decoy and snapped a wrister past Franson to give the Bells the lead. Zach Brunel would equalize after some slick stick handling from Francis LeMay, but 24 seconds later, Silva and Southwell hooked up again, with the latter whacking it past Franson for his second of the game. Silva would then put it away with a short side snipe to give the Bells their second 4-2 win of the weekend. They headed home to San Jose happy with 8 points out of a possible 12, and neither of their losses came in regulation. The only other game in the league this past weekend was another blowout victory for Caneo Valley as they trounced La Jolla Country Day 9-2. Alessandro Vanelli led the offensive onslaught with a goal and 4 assists. Looking at the Varsity D1 standings, Bellarmine jumps up into a tie for third place with the Servite Friars. The Bells only surrendered 8 goals in regulation or OT during the weekend, showcasing quite impressive defense. Meanwhile, OLU retained their stranglehold on first place at 5-0, while the Chargers used their win over Bellarmine to climb into sole possession of second place at 4-2. In Varsity Division 2, Caneo Valley improved to 5-1 on the season, while Corona-Norco picked up their second win to move into a three-way tie for fourth. La Jolla Country Day and Newport-Mesa are still left searching for their first wins. This weekend, we have a 5-game slate of broadcasts split between both halves of our great state of California, starting in NorCal, where the Bells will host their first 2 games of the season, both against Servite. They'll square off at 7:30 p.m. on Halloween night and then get up early on Saturday to face off again at 8 a.m. Note that those are Black Dog Enterprises only broadcasts. Meanwhile, back in Anaheim, we'll have 3 of our usual simulcasts with SportsnetUSA.net starting at 2:30 p.m. with a Varsity D2 Game of the Week between Upland Christian and Long Beach Prep. Then at 4:30 p.m., it'll be a rematch of last season's championship game when Santa Margarita and JSerra hit the ice. They'll be followed by the 2 squads currently sitting atop D1 at 6:30 p.m. as Edison will take on Orange Lutheran. That does it for this week's report. For the ADHSHL, I'm Andy Dickerson. So long. So put your money where your mouth is.